Huddle up, huddle up. Christina, you go for a bomb. Jimmy, you go for a down and out. You guys block the line. Ready, break!
Teamwork is very important at St. Basil's because if we don't really do teamwork, we can't really get along. The best example I can give you is dorm life. Living with girls, my peers and stuff is the greatest, you know, and sometimes we have our ups and downs, and it's okay because as a team, we work together and we talk those things out.
Determination is important to me because it helps you succeed in life. It helps you to overcome obstacles, keep things good, make sure people don't get in your way, and when they do, overcome them, push them out of your way, and keep going.
Come on, line, give me the protection I need. Ready, set, fight, split.
Well, with me, depending on others, they're always there for you no matter what. And they'll talk to you, you can let out all your feelings to them, and it's just, they won't go back and say anything to anybody, so I do depend on people like here for lots of reasons.
Ellie, the ball's been throwing, throw it! Touchdown, touchdown!
Hi, I'm Pat Summerall, and sports has been a big part of my life. First as a high school, college, and pro football player, and then for more than four decades as a sports commentator on television and radio. During that time, I've seen countless games, scores of championships, determined by one touchdown, in some cases by one or two points. And it seems to me that the deciding factors are which athletes have the strongest sense of teamwork, which players have the greatest determination, who has the strongest sense of personal dependability. And as I've watched athletes move from sports into positions as successful executives, as effective parents, as influential religious and civic leaders, I'm more and more convinced than ever that kids learn valuable life lessons while playing games like football with their friends and schoolmates. Unfortunately, I've also observed that the playing fields of life are not always level, and the lessons learned aren't always the best.
When I was 4 years old, my dad died, and my mother didn't speak English very well. And so my godfather brought us here to St. Basil's when I was five and my sister was three.
The neighborhood that I come from in Washington Heights has a lot of drugs, a lot of gangs, a lot of violence, crime.
I'm not around gangbangers anymore. I'm not around drugs. I'm not around any bad stuff.
20 years ago, I think children were coming primarily because a parent died. Now, more of the children are coming because they're being referred by state agencies, they're victims of abuse, their parents are chemically dependent, or they're just from a poor single-parent home.
Many of them come from underprivileged families, have not had toys, have not had sometimes enough food to eat. So a big part of their experience when they come to St. Basil's is just satiating themselves with these basic things that they've always needed, but most likely never gotten.
My mom and dad are they're apart, and I haven't seen them in like 2 months because I really didn't want to go home.
I haven't seen my dad for the past 2 or 3 years. I haven't spoken to him for the past 7, 8 months. So it's difficult not being around both parents.
The tragic reality is that children come from environments that are harsh to them. A parent, there's divorce, there's emotional illness, physical illness, addiction, chemical, substance abuse, combination of all of the above, death. All those things are what have impounded upon the life of the children, and they need to be here.
For the first time in their lives, I think many children feel safe and secure and know that there's consistency in terms of how they're treated, what's expected of them, and they become more accountable for themselves as well. I think that that's a gift to be able to do that for a child who has no structure and no background.
My brother and I came here after the death of our mother. Our father was also very ill and could no longer care for us. It took a lot of courage to overcome heartache and homesickness, but we quickly became not only students here at St. Basil Academy, but also members of the extended family. Here we were safe from life's uncertainty and from the violence which so often affects kids in the neighborhood we came from. Here at the academy, I learned to bounce a basketball and throw a shot put, to try things for myself, to do things I never thought I could, to work independently, and to be a team player. Here I learned about nature and about God and His love. Here I dreamed about my future, and here I laid the personal and spiritual and academic foundation to make my dreams come true. I cannot think of a better place to be educated, to grow, to live as an adolescent growing into adulthood. All of you at the Academy, with patience and Christian love, helped me become what I am today.
More than half a century, this has been a very special place. A comfortable 260-acre campus featuring stately buildings, dense forest lands, rich flowering meadows, and an awe-inspiring view of West Point just across the Hudson River. Here at St. Basil Academy, youngsters from troubled families have found a haven of hope, an environment of encouragement, a place where they could begin building a future filled with promise.
It's so rewarding to hear the stories from the alumni, especially when they come back for their annual reunions, about the successes they've had in their lives, in their careers, because of the nurturing, the caring, and Christian environment that they grew up in here at St. Basil Academy. These alumni have gone on to become great parents, successful business owners, state senator, dental professionals, lawyers, just about anything you can think of. And they were able to do that because they grew up in a Christian, nurturing environment that built their self-confidence and enabled them to do what they wanted to do.
Whether we're speaking of athletic skills or life skills, success depends on being well-grounded in the fundamentals. And at the Academy, we know and we teach our children that all of life's fundamental values rest on the bedrock of our spiritual faith.
For many of the children, the first time in their lives, they're coming to know Christ and the church and the embracing environment of that church.
A lot of our kids come to us when their faith is compromised. Almost everything that they've cared about has been taken away from them, and they don't understand why.
The children are learning. We are reteaching, or teaching perhaps in many instances for the first time, what it means to be a Greek Orthodox Christian, to be a citizen of the society and the world.
A lot of them will show up at our doorstep saying, well, I don't believe in a God, because if there were a God, how could this have happened to me? And actually, when they're in that state, is a great time for us to intervene and reach them on a spiritual level.
And they talk to me privately and even as a group sometimes after a dinner meal about this person named Jesus. How does he impact their lives? And he does, and they're learning that.
So sometimes it's not even about restoring what was, it's giving them something that's totally new.
Through the on-campus prayers, the regular celebration of the liturgy, and through my personal times of prayer and Bible study, the spiritual life at St. Basil Academy became an integral part of my being. And through the years since I graduated, I have drawn strength and courage from the knowledge of God's love. I find comfort and encouragement in the liturgy, and I know that to the extent that I seek His guidance, I will receive from Jesus Christ His perfect wisdom and His divine guidance. My time at the Academy was the most influential period of my life. Words cannot adequately express my gratitude to those who have offered their prayers on our behalf, who have invested their time and energy in the lives of young people like me, who have provided the financial resources that ensure that St. Basil Academy will continue to make a difference in the lives of boys and girls for generations to come. It is my hope and prayer that our patron saint, St. Basil, will continue to give his guidance and direction to all the faculty, the staff, and the students, as he did for me.
Two white dots are your old fillings, and your other area here is a little bit of a cavity.
Here at St. Basil Academy, we also believe that a sound body relates to a sound soul. We have volunteers come about once every month to take care of their dental needs. We do their checkups, we do their examinations, we do their any kind of maintenance procedures for them. We can do from root canals to cleanings to fillings and any kind of services that that the children need. We have medical doctors volunteering their time to give vaccinations or any kind of emergency services that may be needed. Some of the children have their own physicians, so it's more of a maintenance program for the children if they need any kind of medical treatment that the doctors would come in as volunteers. I think it's important that the children have this type of availability for them, and I think also the medical and the dental societies of New York have definitely helped out in sending us volunteers to be able to really help the students get back to their perfect medical and dental health.
Powers Lincoln's decision to issue the Emancipation Proclamation.
Certainly at St. Basil Academy, a child has the opportunity to experience a sound soul and to develop a sound body. But thanks to a dedicated staff and scores of consistent volunteers, each child here can develop a sound mind as well.
The children of the last 3 years approximately are going to the public school, and it's the same school district that educates the children of the West Point Military Academy personnel. So we're very pleased with the quality of education. As a result of public school education, they're receiving all the services that they need.
Advantages of children going to public school settings versus children staying here on campuses are many. Children get the opportunity to deal with their peers in a community setting. They get to work in recreational courses. They get to meet outside teachers and have outside influences.
I think it's socially a very positive experience. They get to integrate themselves with kids from many other backgrounds. And I think it's wonderful where we're located. West Point is one of the most diverse areas with kids from all over the country.
We're able to intervene in their academic programs and catch it if they're not doing their homework, if they're not progressing, and then offer the support as the family unit, surrogate, to make that happen, to make them improve and grow.
My grades went up like 100% in English, especially in math. I get like all A's now, which is much better for me, especially since I want to go to college.
These children are interacting with other children. They're being better prepared for the world and world reality. That socialization that happens, you know, it becomes problematic for us because they're making friends. They want their friends to come over here. They want to go there. But you know what? That's normal life, and that's what we want. And that happens, again, under our supervision. So we have children who come to visit, and they spend a night, and they want to spend another night and another night. But it's great for the kids, for our kids, because our children feel proud of where they are.
There are scores of unsung heroes at the Academy. We get hundreds of volunteers every year, whether they're young adults, Boy Scouts, Philoptojos members, alumni, people from the neighborhood. They come to the Academy. They help with chores. They help with administration. They've rebuilt buildings. They've painted the chapel. In fact, last week we had a group here from Chicago who painted the exterior of the chapel. They were all teenagers and they really had fun doing it. And everybody comes here because they love the children.
All the volunteers come and they give their time and their love to the children. As a volunteer myself, it's very special and very precious to me to see the smile on their faces. You know, either last night I baked cookies with them and we made a cake. They were so excited to be able to do something different. Either you take them out shopping or you take them out to ice skating or for an ice cream. It's just to get away from the campus for a few hours or an hour, it's great for them. And they know how much they're being loved.
I've been involved in many organizations and institutions, but I could tell you quite honestly, the staff here at St. Basil Academy is second to none. They live for this academy.
I have staff members that are here to help me I have Father Costa, who I can talk to, and, you know, it's just like living at home where you can do different activities. You have your, you know, friends that are like your brothers and sisters.
Well, the counselor's here if I'm feeling upset or if I'm feeling happy. No matter what the situation is, I could go talk to them. Like, they're a very good friend to me.
This is a very unique situation, and I encourage all of you to come and visit St. Basil, because no matter what words I use in describing them, it does them an injustice. Come and visualize how the children interact with the staff. See their professionalism. They have credentials from psychologists, nutritionists, nurses, so on and so forth. The staff is a wholesome staff that works well together, work as a team, and it's truly a family environment. St. Basil is that family the children never had.
I stopped by our little girls' dormitory, and I went in, and they were having dinner, and I just wanted to get a feel for it. And it was six children with their counselor sitting around the kitchen table and having dinner. And they asked me to join them, and I did. And it was just chitter-chatter, the conversation, Father Costa this, and we did this, and that, and that. And you know what it was? It was a real family. They take care of each other, too.
I get up 6 o'clock in the morning to go to school. I come back at 2 in the evening. Between 2 o'clock to 4 o'clock, we have like a study hall, so where we do our homework and stuff. We can go to the library. After that, we have church at 5:30 and till 6 o'clock. And then at 6 o'clock, we go back to our dorms and have dinner.
That's the Monday through Friday schedule. Saturday, the children sleep in. And I smile because they like that. Sunday, we all go to church, like your normal Greek Orthodox Christian family. The major difference is that we're a larger family. And really and truly, we have some more serious problems than your typical family. And we also have to take care of those. And we do, with clinical staff, with a nurse, with a doctor that's 5 minutes away. All of that we take care of. Imagine, just like you, imagine your family. And we are a family like that.
When I came to St. Basil Academy, I was what could be charitably described as a difficult child. I was separated from my family and familiar surroundings. I had difficulty taking on the most simple responsibilities, making my bed, doing my assigned chores, completing my homework. But through the difficult times, my dorm supervisor loved me and encouraged me. She helped me learn to respect others and myself. Little by little, she gave me responsibility until I learned to take responsibility for myself. Firmly, yet lovingly, she held me accountable for my actions and taught me how to hold myself to high personal standards. Even though at that point in my life I was sometimes scared and sometimes felt very much alone, she heard my voice when no one else did, and she helped me hear my inner voice and draw on my inner strength. When the road that I've traveled since leaving the academy has become rocky, when I've encountered criticism from myself and others, I've found strength and courage in her praise. In fact, when I was taking my bar exam and was so nervous I could barely write my essays, I could hear her voice reinforcing my voice until my voice got so loud that the world listened.
During the early decades of the 20th century, the late Archbishop Athenagoras envisioned an appropriate home for an orphanage and women's teaching academy. In 1944, the summer estate of the late Colonel Jacob Rupert, nestled along the banks of the Hudson River, became available. The property's location, close to New York City, was especially attractive. The sprawling woods and open fields would provide a natural and healthy environment and home for the children. The Archbishop's dream became a reality. The National Philoptahos Ladies Society initiated an appeal throughout the Greek Orthodox community and secured the funds to purchase the property. Because of the limited availability of suitable living quarters, the academy originally accepted only girls. During the 1950s, under the leadership of the late Archbishop Michael, through renovation and new construction, the original boys' dormitory was added developed and the housing for girls was improved. An ambitious program of building and a refocusing of the Academy's vision continued during the 1960s under the energetic and progressive leadership of Archbishop Yakovas. Over the years, many have contributed their time, their talents, and their treasure to continue this vital ministry to children in need. And throughout the history of St. Basil Academy, the vital concern and constant personal participation of the members of the National Philoptahos Ladies Society has kept alive the vision of Patriarch Athenagoras. And the light of life in the children's eyes has been their constant reward.
It has been said that no one stands so tall as when one stoops to help a child. And no one is more aware of this than the Greek Orthodox Ladies Philoptahos Society. We have focused on St. Basil's now for 50 years. St. Basil's Academy is our primary ministry, and we will continue to strive and work to make it better than it has ever been and the best that it can be.
When one looks at the success of St. Basil Academy, one definitely has to acknowledge the Philoptahos, both on a national level and on a local individual, diocesan and parish level. Their commitment, dedication, and unending love to this fine institution has always allowed us to reach and fulfill our goals here at the Academy. Aside from Philoptahos, there have been many other organizations, such as our Scouts, young adults, individual parishes, different projects by different dioceses, which have aided and helped this institution achieve its goal. Other organizations, such as AHEPA, Daughters of Penelope, many other fraternal organizations, have added to the success. They are all committed to St. Basil Academy, and for that, we are grateful and we appreciate their support.
We have in the Gospels, when we have all the events related to Christ, we have a number of very beautiful scenes, very telling scenes. I think one of the most outstanding is a case in the Gospel of Matthew, when children at a certain instance approached the Lord. He was busy preaching, moving among the people, and the disciples interfered, saying, just let the children be eliminated, we have something else to do here. And Christ says, no, let the children come to me, because theirs is the kingdom of God. And in another instance, he took a child, tenderly placed in the midst, and make it an example for the grown-ups. So we have this type of scenes in the Gospel that show the very particular sense that Christ wanted to convey related to the care for children, especially if the children are in condition of needing very particular care, as it is the case with St. Basil's Academy.
As contemporary as we think we are, there was a saint of the church in the fourth century that was even more modern in his thinking than we are. And he envisioned a place where the needs of people would be met in a community, a family, a larger extended, small village, but a community. And he wanted to take care of the widow, the orphaned, the elderly. And that's why Archbishop Athenagoras of Blessed Memory established this place. So in that scheme, and with that vision, we've now dedicated a building for any clergy who are widowed or celibate that really don't have a support system as far as a family, where they can live out their golden years of life. We're looking with the possibility, an open mind, to have a senior residence, perhaps apartments where elderly can be here with the children. St. Basil understood the beautiful dynamic of older people with children, like a foster grandparent type program. We're looking to open it as a home to all people.
We are trying to do at St. Basil what we call the Vasiliada concept, or the kingdom concept, where we will cater to the entire community. The retreat center is going to be a state-of-the-art facility, which we will be able to house in the initial stage 100 people per night. Why? we will be able to serve our community better. We need to have a place where we can go, where we could train on different topics, seminars, missions, not just the youth, the young adults, the scouts, the seniors, the clergy, the choir. We need a place where people can come to and utilize. We have the space, we have the ability, and we have the desire, and that's where we're going.
The future of the Academy is dependent on the establishment of a solid base. And that base is an endowment fund that will allow us to continue providing a Christian home for our children in need, and also to expand our programs, the retreat center, retirement home for clergy, and many other programs that will benefit the entire Archdiocese at large.
The greatest gift that we received was the selfless act of Jesus going on the cross and shedding his blood. Anything we do in response to that is little. The love that he showed for us, we have to respond to and give. And how do we do that? We do it by giving of our time and talents, of offering our services, and here at St. Basil, many volunteers come. And in a more real way, we give with, not that that isn't real, but a tangible way is giving our financial resources and helping to make this ministry as viable and as solid and as beneficial to the children as possible. We talk about their education. You've got to pay a tutor. Tutors go from $35 to $70 an hour. If you're talking about feeding them, someone has to pay the cook. Someone has to pay for the food. So we want to establish an endowment that will secure the institution and the basic needs, paying the oil bill, the electric bill, maintaining the physical structure, which is a jewel for us, and always having children that we can benefit, that we can take care of, and not having to go begging and borrowing, which we will do for the glory of God in response to the selfless act of love that he did for us.
There are many ways you, your parish, and your organization can participate in this ministry. Volunteer service on a daily, a weekly, or periodic basis. Sponsorship of a child, underwriting educational opportunities, or hosting a child for weekends away from campus. Participating in local or regional fundraising activities. Providing a philanthropic gift to provide long-term underwriting of these ministries. There are more ways to help than we have time to list. So call the Academy's office, and the staff will be happy to give you some additional suggestions. And remember, every little bit helps. It helps the boys and girls, and it helps you too.
You give and you open your heart to a reception of immense treasures of knowledge, experience, and this feeling of the eyes of the receiver looking at you beyond what his or her words would express. And people who do that would never forget the very grateful expression in the face, especially of children. And this would be the best thing that they could do by just giving.
The legacy of St. Basil Academy is not bricks and mortar, grounds and buildings, programs implemented, or projects completed. Rather, the legacy of St. Basil Academy is boys and girls who leave this place to become productive members of society. Vibrant members of our parishes, boys and girls who grow into men and women of character, men and women of spiritual strength, men and women who will light the way for those who follow. Now we invite you to partake of the privilege of continuing this legacy, providing the financial resources to ensure that the vision of St. Basil Academy will continue to be a reality today, tomorrow, and for generations to come.
The ministry of St. Basil Academy is a ministry that typifies the heart and soul of the church. As our ministry partner, you can make an eternal difference in the lives of boys and girls in need. You can leave a legacy of changed lives.
Anyone who has ever gotten involved or helped St. Basil Academy with their time, talents, or money, it has changed their life. That's the simplicity of it.
Helping your fellow man and giving and sharing. There is nothing more rewarding than doing just exactly that.
Well, I don't know where I would be without them right now. They just help me so much. You feel like a real presence of God here, I guess you could say.
St. Basil is going to help me, my mom, my brother, my sisters. get all back together and stay as one big family again.
There are a lot of kids here who need someone to care for them.
I always remember St. Basil's and the love and care that they gave me.
When we can change the life of one child, we feel fulfilled, and we also know that our Lord and Savior is smiling upon us.